Women are to be given clear information condition about the benefits
that can be managed
with a lot of bruises on his body and had unexplained fevers for about 2 weeks.
I'm here today because
I decided to go to the doctor because we obviously concerned with his own people and they did some lab work to find out that he was really ill. Laura was born a perfectly healthy baby. We had no idea that there was anything wrong until after her 6th birthday.
It comes as a bolt from the blue. You have a child who, to all intents and purposes, is developing perfectly normally.
The first signs that I noticed was when she began holding her reading books a little bit closer.
It may well be seeing the blackboard at school, or they may have a seizure first, and then it becomes apparent that something is terribly wrong.
I decided to make an appointment to go and see Professor Moore at the Moorfield Eye Hospital. He asked me how Laura's health had been generally. As soon as I mentioned this seizure, he went very, very pale, and I knew in that moment that something really, really bad was about to happen.
Well, Batten disease is just one of a group of horrible diseases that are devastating. It's going to get progressively worse. They'll lose the ability to walk and to talk and to feed themselves and will end up in a wheelchair. And sadly, they will all die because there's nothing we can do to treat them at this stage.
We felt like, like we'd been hit by a lorry emotionally. It was just such an enormous shock. Laura has obviously lost her vision. She's suffering major epileptic seizures now. Her mobility has declined. She's increasingly disorientated. She's also having problems with memory. Communication is becoming more and more of a problem. It affects many, many different aspects of Laura's life. So we just try and make life as interesting as we can in the house by doing activities together, like cooking or like going and gathering things in the garden or spending time with pets, playing games. Laura has a brother called Thomas, and Thomas has adapted to Laura's disabilities brilliantly and is a real support to her. Laura has always remained positive despite really significant and huge adversity. When you are given a diagnosis about your child that it has Batten disease, you are told that there are no treatments and that there is no cure.
And perhaps the worst thing is, because there is nothing that we can do, that family are effectively watching their child slip away in front of them.
Sparks Charity are doing a fantastic job. You know, there is so little funding for that type of medical research.
What we're trying to do is to find a way that we can actually slow down part of this disease and treat it more effectively. We're very fortunate now that we're in a position to start doing these studies.
And many of the breakthroughs have happened in that laboratory, and the work that's being done there is of global significance.
So Spark's contribution to this project is absolutely invaluable. And that's true for the wide range of different projects that they're funding. And without their support, none of those projects would actually be happening. And there wouldn't be as much hope for these children.
There is real hope that we will be finding treatments and possibly even a cure for Batten disease. What that means, of course, is that children will be saved from having to go through what my own daughter has had to go through.